Hello friends, friends, today you will study a very important topic of evolution, and this is pattern of evolution. And first of all, the important pattern is adaptive radiation, and actually you know that natural selection can ultimately lead to the formation of new species. Sometimes many species evolve from a single ancestral species. Similarities in skeletal and muscular structure of Hawaiian honey creepers led scientists to conclude that the 23 species of honey creepers had evolved from one ancestral species. Therefore, you can define here adaptive radiation. That this is an evolutionary pattern in which many related species evolved from a single ancestral species. This is the adaptive radiation. Understand that you can again define, remember this thing, that and this is an evolutionary pattern in which many related species evolved from a single ancestral species. And it mostly occurs when a species of organism successfully invade an isolated region where few competing species exist. If new habitats are available, then new species will evolve. For example, finches of Galapagos Island. This is the example in which one species gives rise to multiple species that exploit different niches. There are 14 species of finches on the Galapagos Island. Each fills a different niche on different islands. All of them evolved from one ancestral species which colonized the island only a few million years ago, and the ancestral finch was ground-dwelling, seed-eating finch. Next pattern is parallel evolution. And it is the development of similarities in separate but related evolutionary lineages through the operation of similar selective factors on both lines. It is similar to convergent evolution in that similar adaptations arise in different species. The main difference is that in parallel evolution, the two species have a relatively recent common ancestor. And next is co-evolution. It is used to describe cases where two or more species reciprocally affect each other. Evolution, for example, an evolutionary change in the morphology of a plant might affect the morphology of a herbivore or so on. Co-evolution is likely to happen when different species have close ecological interactions with one another. These ecological relationships include mutualistic species, competitive species, predator or prey, or parasite or host. Plant and insects represents a classic case of co-evolution, one that is often but not always mutualistic. Many plants and their pollinators are so reliant on one another that their relationships are so exclusive that biologists have good reason to think that the match between the two is the result of a co-evolutionary process. We can see exclusive matches between plants and insects even when pollination is not involved. Some Central American acacia species have hollow thorns and pores at the bases of their leaves that secrete nectar. These hollow thorns are the exclusive nest site of some species of ant that drink the nectar. The ants are not just taking advantage of the plant, but they also defend acacia plant against herbivores. This system is probably the product of co-evolution. The plants would not have evolved hollow thorns or nectar pores unless their evolution had been affected by the ant, and ants would not have evolved herbivore defense behaviors unless their evolution had been affected by the plants. Next is convergent evolution. When unrelated animals converging on the same form or structure because that form is very adaptive in their common environment, such evolution is known as convergent evolution. It describes the acquisition of same biological trait in unrelated species. For example, streamlined shape of sharks and dolphin. Sharks are the cartilaginous fishes and dolphins are mammals, and they are related to one another in only the most distant sense. But if its life depends on swift movement through the water, then a streamlined shape is much essential. Example number two is wings in birds, bat and flies. Convergent evolution produces analogous structure in contrast to homologous structure, which have a common origin. Similarity among unrelated organisms as a result of convergent evolution is known as homoplasy. The wings of birds, bats, and insects are homoplastic features because the common ancestor of these three groups lacked wings. For example, among plants, spines, that is modified leaves, and thorns, that is, these are the example of the homoplasy. And spines and thorns look similar and both provide protection to the plant, but the plants to which they belong are distantly related. Homoplastic similarity can be anatomical, physiological, or behavioral. Next is divergent evolution, the process in which two or more related species become more or less dissimilar, that is, that similarity is due to the common origin. This evolution produces homologous structures. For example, Darwin finches, very classic example. They have over 80 varieties which all diverge from one original species of finch. For example, organisms with 5-digit pentadactyle limbs like human, bats, and whales, they all have evolved from a common ancestor. So, pattern of evolutionary changes, that is, the most evolution consists of two processes. Number one, anagenesis. That is phyletic evolution. Second is cladogenesis, that is branching evolution. So, anagenesis is the progressive evolution of species involving a gradual change in gene frequency in an entire population. When enough mutation reach fixation in a population to significantly differentiate from an ancestral population, then a new species name may be assigned. The entire population is different from the ancestral population so that the ancestral population can be considered as extinct. When a species is transformed over time by the acquisition of phenotypic and genetic modification, then there is no increase in the number of species. Next phenomena is cladogenesis, that is branching evolution. It is the evolutionary splitting event of a gene pool into two or more separate pools, which give rise to one or more new species. It can promote biological diversity by increasing the number of species. Now, this is the picture concerned with the anagenesis. That is, a species changes over time until it is so different from its progenitor that it is classified as a new species. So, species 1 changes into species 2, that is, in the time, over time, many time, after many time. And in cladogenesis, species 1, you can see it is differentiated into 2 or species 2, species 3. That is, here speciation take place as a branching process wherein one species becomes two or more species. So, this is the difference between anagenesis and cladogenesis. This is all about the pattern of evolution. And like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.